Hi traders, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I hope all of you are doing good. Today I'm shooting this video from my new house. I'm happy to excited and thanks for all your blessings. So today the topic what we are going to cover is the trading psychology. Most of the time people neglect this topic and they don't understand what is the risk reward they have to potentially take care of when trading. And it's a very easy subject. Not everybody understands how to actually do this. They often tend to get into more of a learning mode of technical analysis, fundamental analysis, this strategy, that strategy. They try multiple strategies and they keep hopping strategies from one place to another, which is the biggest mistake you do. Trading is all about the probability, and the probability has to be managed with proper risk management. So the first thing what you need to learn is risk management. So it is a simple game. Like if I have to tell you that if I do a coin flip 10 times and every time I lose only 100 rupees, and every time I win 200 or 300 rupees, will you be profitable in that scenario? The answer is yes. So this is how you need to do trading also. Always your strategy should be defined and your risk to reward should always be 1:2, 1:3, or at least 1:1. Most of the people, what they do is that they tend to do a mistake of losing for more than what they make. That's the biggest mistake what they do. And in that kind of trading, you always, one day you make 10,000 and another day you lose 30,000. So that is not the way of trading you should do. Always your losing should be in your control. It should not be in control of the market, and you should not leave it open. Most of the options sellers also, they do not practice stop losses, and they keep making money every day, and suddenly one day they will lose a big chunk of that or maybe they lose more than what they have made till now. So maybe you'll be able to see a lot of people posting intraday profits every day, and suddenly you will see they will not post for one day. That one day could have actually taken away the entire month's profit. So that's how you have to be very cautious from whom you are learning and what you are learning, and always work with strategies, hedge strategies, and always understand your risks and reward first. And always try to log and maintain a database and a ledger of what you're trading. So this will actually help you in terms of understanding how you have done in overall trading, and are you profitable. Also capture the taxes and costs involved in that. So without further ado, let's get started with our technical analysis on the screen. Let's get started. Traders, here I'm on the Bank Nifty chart. So as you can see, we are on a monthly time frame. Monthly time frame, what is the Bank Nifty saying? This is the candle for this month. Okay, so here the candle is retracing from this previous level. This was the level where Bank Nifty came into this zone, and from there it started bouncing up. And next candle was a good bullish, and it has taken the high of this bar. Now this zone is acting as a support for this month's price. So the price came till here, but it got very good support and it is now moving up. If things go well in this next 4 days, this candle might actually close a little higher, or it can close like this month. And next month candle, if it opens here, then it might, if it takes away the high of this candle, then definitely it's going to form a new high. This was the previous high and this will be the new high. So there is a high chance that next month, which is July, can be the month where there can be a heavy bullishness. Depends upon the overall market. Or there can be a scenario where if this closes like this and the next candle opens here and it's breaking the low of this candle, then it can come down like this.
even this is possible because we are seeing a kind of consolidation at this level after a new high. Okay, so maybe it'll stay for some more time here and then starts to pop. So let's see how it happens for this one. This is on a higher time frame, and let's go to a weekly time frame and see whether our assumptions are fitting right on the weekly time frame. Yes, on a weekly time frame we can see this was a narrow candle. What was the high of this candle? The high of this candle was around 35380. What is the high of this week's candle? It is 35491. So it has already taken the high of this candle at a 20 period moving average level. So this can be a good support. This is a good support for the market. And here it is moving up. So we can expect a candle which can be higher from this level for this week. Okay, high chances, or it can be a narrow range candle also. One or two candles may come and then boom, can give big candle. This is also possible because we are considering this 20 period moving average as a support, because whenever it came near this area, it's always got the support and moved up. Even now it is moving up till the time we don't have any major bad news coming in the market. Okay, so that's on a weekly time frame. Let's see if the correlation is right on multiple time frames. Monthly we were bullish, and weekly we were bullish, and on a daily basis also we are seeing a bullish trend. How am I saying that? I'm saying because here you see this was the pattern, and this is price is still holding the 20 period moving average, and this candle, that is yesterday's candle, closed above the 20 period moving average, which is a very good sign and bullish sign for us. It can go higher from here, or it can stay in this zone, not give you a breakout like this, but stay in this zone for some time, because this has become a zone. You can stay here, come here, stay here, come here, and then again give a breakout like this. Since the 200 period is also rising, 20 is also rising, it can go up mostly, because I don't see any bad news coming in so far, as the vaccination drive is also on the up move only, and we are vaccinating more and more people on a daily basis, so that's also a good sign. And now the normal market conditions will play a trick here, like earlier how before corona, how news is related to parties, companies, all these things will start affecting the market. The major bad news is already gone. So let's see this on a 3-minute time frame how it looks like. Okay, I want to also show you the beauty of super trend in this particular thing. See, whenever you follow this super trend, it's a pretty decent indicator, which can give you an entry here. See the entry here, and after this, the market has never came close to the super trend. Only time it came close, and even if you exit here as a super trend as your trailing stop loss, you could have made a decent money from here to here. But in a sideways market, this super trend will actually kill you, because it will go up, it will come down. So let me just show you the sideways days also, where it will like cross 3 to 4 times. Here it is. So you can see in this day. Okay, so this was a typical sideways day. You see, super trend gave a short entry here. Okay, till here you are able to make some money. If you are able to trail and exit, this is fine. Again, you got a long entry, but it didn't go up again. It took your stop loss neutral. Again, it came up, gave you a long entry, didn't go up, short entry, long entry, short entry. So this is how in sideways market you should always ignore super trend signals. But how do we identify whether it's a sideways market or going to be trending day? That is a tricky part, and that's the reason you always need this kind of other things like moving average and 200 period moving average and RSI, which tells you most of the time if the price is, you need to watch the first minute. So the price is going below the 20 and coming above the 20 and again going below the 20, if this pattern forms, then you can say that it is going to be a sideways. Okay, but in this sideways also, if you notice, you will not be losing much. You entered here, you exited here, you entered here. But you know, what I do personally is that I always go and cross check the trend on a 15 minute time frame. Okay, so this day you check the trend on a 15 minute time frame. If the first 15 minutes is giving you a short entry, stick to this only. Okay, do not get confused by this. This was on 23rd June. Yeah, this was a 23rd June. Here, if you see on 22nd onwards, the super trend is showing bearishness. So always match your current intraday super trend with the 15 minute trend. 3 minute trend should match the 15 minute trend and stick to this. If the 3 minute trend is going up and down, stick to the 15 minute trend and stay bearish with this. You could have definitely not lost money, but made some money here, but there you could have got out neutral. And after that entry, see the kind of move we have got here. So always look at the 15 minute time frame if you are trading intraday and match the indicator so that there is no confusion about it. So I think this week's video is a little bit longer, guys. So let's stop it for this week, and next week we will cover some more stocks. And now regularly I'll be posting more videos because I have time and I have also done a proper setup for my YouTube videos. I hope you like this video, and please do subscribe and share it with your friends so that I can get motivated to make more good videos and provide you proper education. Thank you so much for watching.